My name is Michael Matthews. I'm fighting out of Denver, Colorado from the My Li Mei Martial Arts. I see Todd as a really tough opponent, probably one of the toughest I'm coming up against. He's a great friend. I trained with him a while ago and he hits hard, so I know it's gonna be a challenge. I'm probably looking forward to giving this a good fight and making this a 3-round war at least, you know. I want to give the fans what they want, and I think we can bring it. I'd like to thank all my sponsors, the Sandy Rodriguez family. I want to thank Brawling Combat Gear. I want to thank my fight team, my coaches. I want to thank everybody who's helped me up to this point, my family, my supporters. I want to thank Jeff Cisneros, the promoter, everybody, all the people that help us with this, you know. I want to thank everybody.
My name is Todd, Captain America Meredith, fighting at 190 pounds against Michael Matthews, fighting out of Elevation Fight Team and Grudge Fight Team. See this fight going 3-round battle. Michael's a tough guy, very tall, experienced guy. He's taken a lot of fights on short notice and has never been finished as a pro. So I'm looking forward to a good battle against a good dude. I want to thank all my sponsors and my teammates and coaches for all their support. And then my wife, Christy, for all her love and support.
Ladies and gentlemen, making his way to the cage, fighting out of the Ugly Dog Sports Cafe Red Corner, give it up for Todd, Captain America, Meredith. Fighting out of the Spartan Labs blue corner, give it up for Michael Matthews. This fight is presented by Feature Inner Fat Kid and is the co-main event of the afternoon. Be sure to go to FeatureInnerFatKid.com for all your custom cake needs and beyond. And now, fighting out of the Ugly Dog Sports Cafe Red Corner, this fighter is representing the 303 Training Center and the Grudge Training Center, weighing in at 188.6 pounds, and fighting out of Denver, Colorado, give it up for Todd, Captain America, Meredith! And his opponent, fighting out of the Spartan Labs Blue Corner, weighing in at 187.2 pounds, fighting out of Denver, Colorado, give it up for Michael Matthews.
Okay, gentlemen, we have 3 5-minute rounds in the professional elbows allowed division. Any questions out of the blue corner? Questions out of the red corner? Touch them up now. Let's go.
And here we go, fight fans. 190-pound MMA action coming up. We have Michael Matthews wearing the black and white flame trunks representing Silva's. He's facing off against Mr.
Todd Meredith.
He's fighting for the Grudge Training Center. A lot of people pegged this as fight of the night as soon as this is matched up. Both these guys have been in many fight of the night performances before. Meredith, the guy that's known to always pressure forward, always be in shape. Matthews, a guy that's pretty much known as being nearly impossible to finish.
Yeah, that's a really good way to put it. Probably one of the most exciting guys in Colorado. Actually, both these guys really are some of the most exciting guys in Colorado to watch fight. And as Todd Meredith alluded to in the pre-fight entrance, one of the guys that is tougher than leather, always takes last-minute replacement fights, and as you said, never been finished.
Meredith able to get this fight on the ground. Matthews doesn't mind being there.
Meredith in top position here. He's got Matthews against the cage.
We'll see if Meredith's able to get off a ground and pound game here. So far, Michael Matthews doing a good job tying him up off the bottom.
Meredith known as being a very, very strong guy.
A couple of big shots that we can definitely
hear
the thud on those.
Yeah. Michael Matthews doing everything he can to control the posturing of Meredith from here. Meredith staying busy in the top position with Michael Matthews against the cage, controlling the head. Referee keeping a close eye on the action right now. Meredith looking to get his head out of that position and administer the top ground and pound, especially having Matthews against the cage like that pinned.
And those punches the Merediths deliver, and they're definitely enough to keep the referee happy about letting this fight stay on the ground.
That's right.
They look for damaging punches, and those are definitely some punches that are having some effect.
I'm never a fan of a ref getting too involved in the fight and standing up people too soon. I just don't think it's the right thing to do. You got to let these guys fight. They train in these positions. Let them fight about. Get out of those positions.
And great refs here in Colorado, they're not fans of being real involved in the fights either. They want to be on the outside. They don't want to be noticed. They want to let the fights take care of themselves. And quite often, that's what's happened.
That's a great point.
Good job by Meredith here. Able to pop his head free occasionally. Able to pop his hands free, getting off some striking. Matthews keeping himself from being stopped here, but definitely not getting any offense off yet.
This is definitely where Meredith wants to be. He's obviously got a very good control of the fight from this position right here. You know, with Matthews having that long reach and that long length, obviously staying on the outside of those punches and kicks is not where Meredith wants to be.
Matthews, typically really good job with his sweeps and his escapes. I'm surprised we haven't really even seen him try to get up off of his back yet here, because that's typically something that he's able to do. I don't want to say easily, because his opponents aren't letting him do it, but Matthews typically is able to effect some sort of an escape.
Yeah.
And I think really what we're talking about here is that just speaks to the control of Meredith here.
Yeah. Meredith showing a great top game. Of course, those hips are just devastating when you have somebody underneath you. Being able to control somebody in all positions when they're on their back is critical. And staying busy to deliver that type of punishment from the top is obviously what scores for the judges. So Meredith doing a great job. And you know, on the flip side of that, Michael Matthews doing a great job by not absorbing too much punishment off his back.
Yeah, he's really doing a good job with his defense, trying to handcuff his opponent here, trying to pull his head down, not allowing Meredith to spend a whole lot of time with really good posture. But, boy, when Meredith gets a little bit of posture, he certainly takes advantage of it.
Yeah, he's a powerful guy.
And referee says not enough happening. Kind of surprises me a little bit there, but
me too.
Back to standing we go. Meredith turned his back a little bit there. Matthews looks to take full advantage of that.
That's right.
Matthews popping away with the jab, looking to use that length, putting it to good use here.
And Matthews just coming off of a Muay Thai fight 2 weeks ago in Loveland, and this is where Matthews wants to be. He's got that reach. He's got the gas, and as you said, you know, punches and kicks. He can deliver from all angles, and again, you know, Meredith showing the control of putting Matthews against the cage, which is exactly where he does want him.
And Meredith really good up against the cage.
Yeah.
Really decent with his dirty boxing. A lot of nice Muay Thai techniques that he throws in there. There's the 10-second clacker. It's going to be interesting, Ron. Let's take a look at these fighters in between rounds and see whether or not they seem winded.
I agree.
Good dirty boxing by both to end round one.
You know, and this, as you alluded to, this is basically the fans' call for the fight of the night, and both these guys are not disappointing. All these, you know, both these guys are known as just very, very crafty guys and solid competitors, and it's just great to see these guys delivering.
A couple of tough, durable fighters.
Very much so.
Yep.
What are you telling Michael Matthews?
If I'm Michael Matthews, I'm saying circle. Use your footwork to keep your back from getting against the cage.
Agreed.
Meredith isn't going to try to take you down in the middle of the cage. He's not a great double leg guy. He's going to try to pin you up against the cage, then change levels or body lock you and take you down. I'm saying circle out, try to keep it standing.
Yeah, and if I'm in Meredith's corner.
We'd like to thank our sponsor, CMO Photography. Be sure to check them out on Facebook and follow them on Twitter, CMO Photography.
And while we're thanking sponsors, we want to thank one of Colorado's premier sponsors, Performance MMA. Check them out at www.performancemma.com. Ron, you were saying what you were going to talk about Meredith. Tell us.
Yeah, I mean, if I'm in Meredith's corner, I'm telling him the same thing. I'm saying, look, keep the pressure up against Matthews on the cage. Deliver the dirty boxing, control the fight from there. If you're going to go to the ground, control it from the top position.
And that's what he did in round one.
Yeah.
Matthews comes out, throws a kick, and slips. Good job with his footwork to get his feet back under him. Circles nicely off the cage, gets back to the center. Meredith pressuring forward, trying to pin him up against the cage, able to do exactly that.
What a bull.
Yeah, Meredith really uses his strength. Let's see if he gasses cardio-wise and runs out of strength, and Matthews is able to use his tremendous cardio later in the fight in order to start to pull away.
You know, I know that Meredith has been working quite a bit with CrossFit, trying to get in optimal shape. He's putting a lot of time in the gym. I know he's been working quite a bit. He's bleeding like crazy, though, right now.
That's kind of typical for a Todd Meredith fight. He's one of those guys that loves to get in there and mix it up. Michael Matthews as well. These guys, they just want to be in there in the middle of a fight. And right there when I said Meredith isn't the kind of guy that's going to take you down in the middle of the cage, he gets a nice really outside knee tap and able to take Matthews down to the ground and end up inside the closed guard.
Yeah, and you see that power game of Meredith being visible right now. He's got a good, solid control. Just great hips. I mean, obviously, he's been working some serious body shots right now with Matthews on the ground, bleeding like crazy as only Todd Meredith does, and delivering again for the fans. These guys are going crazy right here.
No doubt about it. And Meredith spent a good portion of round number one here. He was able to keep busy enough to keep the referee happy. And again, like I was saying in round number one, we're really not seeing Matthews try to escape here, and usually he's able to get himself out of these bad positions.
And I think that's a credit to the hips and control game of Meredith. He's really able to keep Matthews pinned up against that cage number one and avoid seeing him standing up where Matthews is most dangerous.
Meredith doing a really nice job here of throwing combinations while he's on the ground. He's not just going with a single strike to a single side to a single target. He's mixing a body. He's mixing it head. He's mixing it right and left. You really couldn't ask for any more as far as the ground and pound goes other than to maybe try to get a few elbows in there.
Yeah. And I think for Matthews,
forearms, I guess. Well, no. Are these guys pros?
Yeah, that's right.
We're in the professional division now. My bad. So, yeah, let's see some elbows.
No, I think – and I think also, too, for Matthews, the key is for him to get out of this bottom position, I think, for him to stand up, maybe get up against the cage, use the cage to his advantage. But really, Meredith is showing just a phenomenal top game, as we expect from him.
Of course. Matthews, like he always is in a fight, he looks pretty nonplussed by the whole situation, looks very calm. He's just kind of, you know, sort of thinking to himself, listening to his corner. He knows what he needs to do, just has to try to start to put that game plan together. But Meredith so far able to shut down everything.
Yeah, yeah. Matthew's one of the nicest guys you could ever meet. It's not surprising to me that he looks like he's smiling in the cage.
Yep. I'll tell you who's another really nice guy. The guy on top of him punching him in the face,
Captain
Todd
America.
Meredith.
Captain America.
In the corner of Meredith saying, just keep going. And I have to agree with that.
Yeah.
He's doing everything right here. He's pounding away. He's scoring points. He's controlling his opponent. He's not taking hardly any damage. He hasn't been threatened by a submission.
Nope. That's why Matthews really has to focus on getting up off the, you know, off his back against the cage, getting up and getting out to the middle of the middle of the cage.
Exactly right. So
Meredith landing some good shots.
3 5-minute rounds here in the professional division. Another difference being that while you're standing, you can knee to the head in the professional division while you're standing up, and you can land with the tip of the elbow as opposed to in the elimination or the amateur division where you're only allowed to land with the forearm. Can't have an arcing strike with the elbow in the elimination division. Here in the pros, slice them open, guys.
J.R. Gordon, the walking encyclopedia of MMA.
Thanks for not calling me Wikipedia.
Not yet. Tough fight for Michael Matthews right now. He's definitely got to get off his back. He's absorbing a lot of punishment on the bottom. Todd Meredith doing a fantastic job just controlling the fight from the top position. Those hips are just all world right now.
Yeah, it's definitely one-way action right now. All Todd Meredith, absolutely just taking over this fight. Think we're going to see a third round, but Matthews has really got to put something together in the third. Do something special if he's going to try to turn this fight around, because so far it's been Todd Meredith showing us why he's a professional level fighter.
I think one of the keys might be for Matthews is to start focusing on some head kicks. I think if we've seen anything from Meredith, he's got that tendency to kind of hunch over a little bit on side, go side to side, which literally sets up perfectly for a head kick by a guy like Michael Matthews.
Dr. Alex Constantinita is in. Really didn't even take that close of a look at Matthews.
Just a flesh wound.
Meredith. Mere flesh wound. He's had worse. Really, he just conferred with the referee. And you know honestly why I think that is, Dr. Alex, he's such a good doctor. They were over there in the corner where the doctor was sitting. I bet he was assessing that cut while they were over there in his corner.
As he always does. You know, and not just a guy that's a spectator, a guy that's actually gotten into the cage and performed too.
Yeah, he's I call him the fighting physician.
Yeah.
He's the only ringside doctor that I've known that actually has a cage fight to his credit.
Not bad, Dr. Alex.
And the reason that he did that is he said, I'm making decisions that can change guys' careers. I need to know what they're going through. Such is the level of his commitment to these fighters. And here we go. So let's see if Matthews is able to keep this standing, able to keep his distance, or if Meredith is able to pressure forward. There's the pressure from Meredith, able to jam Matthews up against the cage.
Yeah, and this is where Meredith has basically won the fight. You know, he's really controlled the action, negating Matthews' reach and length by putting him against the cage and controlling the fight from here. And it's an amazing thing to see when you're watching a guy like this. You know, Meredith is a guy that can literally walk through punches and kicks to get you to the cage.
Being indestructible is a good thing to have on your side during a fight.
As a fighter, it's not bad.
Not a bad skill.
Both of these guys, though. Credit to both these guys.
Yeah, true enough. There we see Meredith looking to drop levels, trying to take that down. Matthews threatened with the kick. So Meredith separated. Now he's got Matthews pushed up against the cage. Corner of Meredith calling for elbows. They wanted some of those in round number two. Didn't get as many as they wanted. Let's see if he's able to start firing off with some of them here in round number three. Off of his back, Matthews starting to cuff away at the ears of Meredith, but that's really not going to be enough to cause much damage.
Right. It'll be interesting to see if Matthews can get up off the cage. I mean, off his back from this position.
Yeah, referee Tim Mills almost stepped in order to stand the fighters up. Meredith fired off a couple of really hard punches. Referee stepped backward, said, yep, that's enough action for me. Now Meredith starting to get off a little better, starting to get his posture.
Meredith is showing a huge improvement in cardio. I mean, he's just literally staying busy the whole time, doing a great job with you know, delivering punishment nonstop. So
and
kudos
that,
to him.
And with that added strength that he brought into the fight, with that added size, I had wondered if that was going to cut into his cardio abilities. Looks like that CrossFit training paying off for Todd Meredith, because he hasn't slowed down one little bit here.
No,
and
he
of
really
course
hasn't.
Michael Matthews hasn't. He never does.
Right.
At the end of this fight, Matthews could step in the cage again and
fight,
go another five rounds.
Exactly right, yeah.
But Meredith just really pounding away. You can hear those body shots thudding away. Very solid.
Staying very, very busy.
Just unrelenting as Todd Meredith, possibly even more so than he was in the first couple of rounds. Really, really working hard to put together those strikes here.
Mike, let go of your fucking guard and get the fuck up. You gotta let go of your guard.
Doing a really good job here controlling the position is Todd Meredith. Matthews finally trying to get himself recovered, finally trying to work himself back to his feet. Able to turn back in, so Matthews in a position where he's going to be able to fire off inside with some dirty boxing. But we've seen time and again, this is where Meredith, able to take control, drops levels, wants the double leg, turns the corner and gets it.
He gets it, absolutely.
So one more time, down on the mat. Michael Matthews, closed guard, trying to wrap up Meredith. Meredith has a hand free, getting in some really solid shots there.
He's really been doing this the whole fight. This is a great way to negate a long reach fighter. At what you're seeing right now is a controlled top game where you're constantly putting pressure on a guy. You know, when a guy has an advantage of reach, it's almost imperative to get him on his back so that he can't use his tools against you. Meredith has just done a phenomenal job with that. Kudos to his wrestling that he's been utilizing. Obviously working with Justin Salas is a huge advantage. Just a great job of what he's been doing, and he's showcasing it here tonight.
Yeah, doing a really great job with that skill set, and really against a fighter like Matthews, you can tell that he's watched the tape. He knew exactly what he had to do. He wasn't going to win this in a stand-up war. Clinched up against the cage, they were going to beat each other up. If he's on the ground in top position, knowing that he can have control like this is where Meredith needed this fight, and that's what he's been able to do.
Yeah.
Is put it there and take advantage.
Yeah. And you know, you were saying it's fighting a guy like Michael Matthews, it's not hard to find footage on him.
Right. There's the 10-second clacker. Looks like we're taking this one to the judges, but I'm going to say this is an easy decision. 30-27 for Todd Meredith. There's the bell. Great fight by both these guys. Matthews gives him the smile, says, thanks for the beating, dude. I hope we get to do it again sometime.
Two class acts. I mean, it doesn't get any better than what you are seeing right there.
Yeah, a couple of great guys in there in the cage helping each other up. Really nice fight by these guys. Like I said, it was tagged early as a chance for fight of the night. We'll see how MMABuzz.com writes it up, if that's their decision for it. But right now, I'd just say thanks to both those guys for putting on such a great performance.
And thanks to MMABuzz.com. That is the premier news website in Colorado for your all, and I'm talking all of your MMA needs. An unbelievable job by you guys.
Much appreciated there, sir. And we're going to take it up to Woody. He'll get the official decision from the judges. And even the banner that they're going to hold up for Meredith has some blood on it right now.
So does my face. So does my clothing.
Think we might need to take a minute for a little cage cleanup after this bout.
Yes.
But after this bout, we're coming back for our main event of the evening. So definitely be ready for that.
Ladies and gentlemen, we go to the judges' scorecard for the decision of this match. All three judges score this fight 30-27 for your winner by unanimous decision, Todd, Captain America, Meredith.
Congratulations,
Grudge Fighter.
I'm here with your winner, Captain America, Todd Merritt. I love the Hulk Hogan theme music. That's awesome, man. Take us through this fight. What a hell of a battle.
Yeah, he's a tough kid. He's known for filling in on last-minute fights. So thank you, Michael, for stepping in and allowing me to have this fight. He's a tough guy. He's still never been finished. I was kind of hoping to do that today, but he was busting me up on the feet there, so I had to get on the ground and, you know, work my stuff down there. So
was there anything that he took you by surprise with on this fight?
He's striking a little bit. His power, honestly. You know, he caught me. He got me a bloody nose, and but tough guy, never quit, and neither did I, I guess. So,
who would you like to thank this afternoon?
I need to thank all my sponsors. I guess they were covered up, but thank you all my sponsors. Thank you everybody for coming out, buying tickets from me or from other fans and all that. Thank you for coming out. Appreciate it. Thank you guys so much.
Todd Meredith, ladies and gentlemen, and give it up for Michael Matthews. He's a hell of a warrior.